cell phones, the internet, credit cards. It's obvious that we live in an age of convenient technologies where shopping online, connecting with friends, and sending information is just a click or a swipe away. But convenience and ease could come at a price you're not willing to pay, your identity.
Identity theft is when a person assumes, possesses, or uses the identity of another without the consent of that person to further any type of criminal activity or gain or purpose. We are seeing much more of it.
Detective Robert Appleby has been with the Lower Sotara Township Police Department since 2001. And since then, the number of reported ID theft crimes has been on the rise.
The Lower Sotara Township Police Department is approximately 15 square miles. And in our township, we see at least 2 to 3 cases of identity theft a month. That's a high number, and I would suspect that bigger departments and bigger jurisdictions deal with a much higher number than we do. We see a lot of where people intercept people's credit card numbers and social security numbers, dates of birth and names online through internet shopping, things like that. One of the biggest things we see is cell phones. A lot of times cell phone accounts will be opened under somebody else's name, and they pretty much use that cell phone until the bill has to be paid.
There's a multitude of ways your ID can be stolen. But the difficult part is this type of crime is just not easily solved.
There are investigative measures we take. A lot of times we'll obtain search warrants to get the IP addresses of the computers used to make the illegal purchases online. And often that's where things get difficult because you may get an IP address on a computer that's listed in Georgia, and the stolen items that were purchased with somebody else's credit card may have been delivered to California. The manpower and resources sometimes just aren't available to do those kinds of investigations.
On the national level, the Federal Trade Commission released its 2008 Consumer Complaint Report. ID theft was the number one complaint category and showed significant increases since 2007. We had a chance to catch up with Todd Davis via satellite. He's the CEO of LifeLock and an expert on ID theft. You might recognize him as the guy who advertises his social security number to the public.
Unfortunately, these desperate times have driven people who would never think about committing a crime, like robbing a convenience store or a bank trying to get money. These people, though, are now tempted because they're desperate. They're getting their foreclosure notices or eviction notices, or their utilities are about to be turned off. While they're sitting there in front of that computer, it's just a little too tempting to search for that personal information, knowing that the probability of getting caught is very low, that even if you were caught, the penalties aren't that great. We've now got a whole new piece of the population that are becoming identity thieves.
What does this mean in terms of direct and indirect costs for America?
This is over a $50 billion, that's with a B, $50 billion a year problem.
What about Pennsylvania? Where does the Keystone State fit into this mess?
The state of Pennsylvania, of course, you're now up there ranked like 18th in the nation, almost 19% growth in the number of complaints filed with the FTC about identity theft in Pennsylvania alone.
Now the tax season is upon us, it's prime time for ID theft in Pennsylvania and across the nation.
So there's two things during tax season. Number one, remember, we're about to put on one document all the keys to the kingdom. You're going to have name, address, birth date, social security number for you and all your dependents. Number two, during the tax season, if you file online, that's okay. I don't want you to shy away from that. I just want you to make sure you don't save a copy of that electronically on your hard drive in a file format. Print it out and put it in some safe storage place somewhere in your home. If you're filing the hard copy, the old form, paper form, just make sure you go put that in the blue mailbox right at the Postal Service. Do not put that out in your mailbox or in the local drop, because the criminals are going to know now's the time to start breaking into mailboxes, because there's going to be more and more tax returns. So look, I may be the guy that's giving out my real social security number all over the place. People saying, is this guy crazy? I'm not crazy. You also gave the information to your employer, your doctor, your dentist, the government, schools, tax accountant, the list goes on and on. The criminals know that that's what they're targeting. The way we're gonna beat this crime is to be proactive. Put a front line of defense in place so that even if someone gets your personal information, they can't or have at least a hard time turning that into money. Because if we make it hard on these criminals, they'll quit stealing the information.
For Smart Talk, I'm Mark Wallace.